What's up, everybody? It's FYGP, and today I want to talk about the suicide of Jeffrey Epstein. Now, I have covered Jeffrey Epstein in many of my previous videos. Unfortunately, most of them have been taken down by YouTube since the channels have been taken, I post them on, have been taken down. And YouTube has basically no free speech. Whenever you have an opinion that doesn't fit the mainstream narrative of something, they will take down your videos. Well, I want to talk about one of the biggest shills in show business, and one of the people who sold out his, you know, his soul, basically, to work for the propaganda media and to hypnotize people into being controlled. And that is, of course, Stephen Colbert. Now, in this video, he's going to talk about Jeffrey Epstein, the alleged pedophile billionaire who might have run a sex trafficking ring of his island, his private island resort. Now, many people were involved with Jeffrey Epstein. Bill Clinton was a very close associate, as was Hillary Clinton, and even Donald Trump had ties to Jeffrey Epstein. So, the way it goes in basically high-level politics and, you know, is that you have to have dirt on people. You have to have dirt on people in order to control them. So, for example, if some senator is a closeted homosexual, you would want to have tapes of him doing, you know, homosexual acts, in order to basically blackmail him and make him do what you want. In the case of many politicians, they happen, you know, to have, you know, they happen, well, yeah, there's surely some pedophiles amongst politicians, that's for sure. And in order to blackmail them, Jeffrey Epstein might have been, you know, the guy for it, you know, basically inviting them in on his private islands to have sex with minors, and basically using this as leverage to make them do what you want. So that is basically what the whole Jeffrey Epstein scandal was about, and there has been many people who have come out and said that Jeffrey Epstein has raped them. Many girls have come out and said that he has raped them. He was even once convicted of sexual assault of a minor and served only a house arrest sentence. So he didn't even go to jail for that. I guess that is the double standard. If you have, you know, billions of dollars, the law doesn't really apply to you. So let's see and how Stephen Colbert is gonna smear anything that has to do with Jeffrey Epstein and his alleged wrongdoing as a conspiracy theory, even though there's ample evidence and facts that Jeffrey Epstein was in fact a pedophile. So let's take a listen.
Colbert, well, here's the thing. I have some good news. I didn't think it was possible, but Donald Trump can still shock me. It's kind of nice, you know? After all these years, he can still keep the relationship fresh, you know? Just when you think he's been around for a while, you're not gonna be shocked by him anymore, he pops up and scares the bejesus out of you. He's like Leatherface, but more leather and way more face. For instance, Stance, over the weekend, sex criminal Jeffrey Epstein was found dead in his New York jail cell. Now, apparently, he, they say, and I guess they would know, though they can't say how, committed suicide, which is surprising because 3 weeks ago he was found unconscious with marks on his neck. How the marks got there, authorities did not share with the public, and yet Epstein was left alone and not closely monitored. Now, maybe
yeah,
he was just in one of those prisons
that really... Right? There's nothing to be suspicious about here. How did he commit suicide exactly? You know, there's supposed to be prison guards around him. Supposed to be people watching him. Supposed to be cameras in the cells as well, as far as I'm concerned. In many prisons, you have that. Well, and there's no, like, objects in the prison cell that you could take your life with. I don't think he had a rope or anything to tie around his neck or something. So that are all questions that need to be asked, and how exactly did he commit that suicide?
Value inmate privacy. Lovely. Then again, Epstein knew a lot of powerful and important people, including Alan Dershowitz, former New Mexico Governor Bill Richardson, Prince Andrew, as well as President Bill Clinton and President Donald Trump. It is a who's who of who's Jeffrey Epstein. I've never met Jeffrey Epstein.
Yeah, exactly, because they...
This is involved.
They didn't want to be associated with him, right?
Wave of conspiracy theories online.
Conspiracy theories. So there we go. There goes the smearing of the free thinkers online. And he's going to say it's all just conspiracy theories.
The sort of stuff that only unstable tinfoil hat loons could...
Unstable tinfoil hat loons. There we go with the tinfoil hat meme. That meme is so old. It's fucking outplayed. It doesn't even, you know, make any sense because no one is wearing tinfoil hats, right? It's basically a thing that they made up about people who distrust the government. That everybody who distrusts the government and has some, you know, theories about the stuff that is really going down is wearing a tinfoil hat. It's complete bullshit.
Possibly believe. So Donald Trump, because after a few hours, Trump fans are coming around. Coming around. Because after a few hours...
But at least he admitted that Jeffrey Epstein is a sex criminal, because up until now he didn't even admit that. But nowhere did he mention that Jeffrey Epstein actually raped underage girls. Did he? He did not mention that. He did not mention the word pedophile, did he?
After Epstein's body was found, Trump shared a tweet and a video that claimed without any evidence that former President Bill Clinton and former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton were responsible for Epstein's death. Really? Really?
Yeah, it's not like the Clintons don't kill any people. It's the Clintons are completely innocent. They have never suicided anyone. They have never suicided anyone. Really? Really? Like, it's so outlandish to believe that Bill Clinton or Hillary Clinton would do something like that. It's not. It's absolutely not outlandish to believe that.
That's your theory? I'm not saying the Clintons don't have any power. They could definitely get a reservation at any restaurant in New York City. Party of four, 7 o'clock on a Saturday, maybe not. But masterminding a scheme to assassinate a high-profile prisoner in a maximum security federal custody. They couldn't even mastermind a visit to Wisconsin.
That one was actually pretty funny because Clinton lost the campaign because he didn't go to states such as Wisconsin. But it's not just the Clintons probably that wanted to see him dead. It's probably some other high profile, really powerful people as well. And, just to believe that because they are out of power, that they have no power at all is completely stupid. So, yeah, I mean, it's not out of this world to believe that somebody suicided Jeffrey Epstein. Somebody who didn't want it to be known that what was going on his private island, right?
But Trump clearly thinks... Trump clearly thinks this is the only logical answer. Follow me down the rabbit hole here, okay? Who had the most to gain from Epstein's death besides me, who was on videotape partying with him and young women? And who controls all federal prisons? The president, Bill Clinton. Really? What? Me? How? Didn't they hear what I said on that bus? That's insane. Yes, it is insane, Mr. President. The President of the United States is pushing a dangerous and completely unfounded murder conspiracy theory about his predecessor. It reminds me of FDR's immortal words.
The only thing we have to fear is Herbert Hoover! He's a lizard alien! They walk among us! Run!
This came. We miss you.
I miss that man.
This came right on the heels of Trump's visits to Dayton, Ohio, and El Paso, Texas. In a time of national tragedy, we look to the president, of course, to console a nation. But Donald Trump was looking to heal a deeper wound, his ego. Aides say that when Trump does something that he believes he should have been praised for, such as Wednesday's visit to the cities, he grows furious when he does not receive accolades. I'd just like to say to all those suffering here in Dayton, you're welcome. Would it kill you to smile? This would explain why, on his way to El Paso, after Trump saw negative news coverage, he screamed at his aides to begin producing proof that in El Paso, people were happy to see him. But not one of the 8 patients still being treated wanted to meet with the president. Look.
So he goes on to another topic. Yeah, exactly. Right, that's what happened. Surely. Yeah, sure, yeah. Something fishy went down. For sure. Exactly. Exactly right. No, but sure, it's just suicide. Yeah, exactly. Conspiracy theory is more like obvious cover-up. Exactly. So yeah, there are some people who obviously push back against the narrative of Stephen Colbert. Stephen Colbert used to be funny. He used to be funny back in the day. It's not the case anymore. It's all just political humor, pushing an agenda, keeping people asleep, hypnotizing them. That's what he's doing. So there's nothing to worry about here. There is no such thing as, you know, rings, sex trafficking rings. No, there is no such thing as that. It's just that, you know, he committed suicide. That's it. He hung himself with toilet paper. That's what happened. That's it for me. See you guys another time. It's FYGP tuning out.